Few words in the Italian dictionary sit closer to an alfista's heart than bialbero, which means twin overhead camshafts. Although there have been twin cam alfas before and since, bialbero is an umbrella term mostly used about the all-aluminium inline four-cylinders made between 1954 and 1994. The small group of engineers, headed by Orazio Satta, started work on the Giulietta project between 1951 and 1952. The Giulietta's inline four-cylinders engine, designed by Giuseppe Busso, had a cast aluminum block with iron liners and five crankshaft supports. The cast aluminum head housed two chain-driven camshafts that operated the two valves per each cylinder directly through bucket-type tappets. Higher-powered road and racing applications were taken into account right from the start, but it's fair to assume even Busso himself couldn't imagine how far his little masterpiece would go over the following four decades of production. While all the Giulietta engines shared the same internal dimensions, power output ranged from 53 to around 100 horsepower, depending on applications. At the bottom of the range, we find the Giulietta Berlina, fed by a single Solex carburetor and capable of 140 km per hour. The beautiful Sprint and Spider count on 65 horsepower thanks to a higher compression ratio and a double choke carburetor. With a virtually identical mechanical specification on the four-door Giulietta TI from 1957, a redesigned exhaust manifold improved these figures from 1958. Still, the hottest Giulietta models went further with their set of side-road Weber carburetors and more aggressive cam profiles. The Giulietta Sprint Veloce, Spider Veloce, Sprint Speciale and, to top them all off, the Sprint Zagato, which joined the range in 1960. The Giulietta allowed Alfa Romeo to successfully ride the wave of new money generated during those years of rapid economic expansion. Such prosperity naturally led to a demand of faster, larger cars, right what the company had in the works. Although the 1.6-liter engine launched with the Giulia in 1962 looked pretty much like the Giulietta's one at a passing glance, it actually was a completely redesigned unit. While the engine's basic layout could not change in order to preserve the existing production tooling, the Giulia engine block had larger diameter main bearings, and the cylinder head's internal dimensions were nearly all different. This is the engine all the inline four cylinders made by Alfa Romeo until the early 90s derived from. This includes the smaller 1.3-liter engine, which equipped the last Giuliettas and the entry-level Giulias that supplanted them shortly after. Throughout the 1960s, the 1.6 and 1.3-liter engines were generally offered in a milder single-carburetor configuration on the base saloons. The more powerful double-carburetor setup was reserved for the GT coupes, Spiders and the saloons' higher trim levels Super, but by the end of the decade, the single carburetor 1.6 was gone, with the 1.3 following suit in 1972. The 1965 Giulia GTA was an extensively lightened variant of the Giulia GT, specifically designed to dominate the European touring car racing scene. Its twin cam 1.6-liter engine was equipped with larger 45mm carburetors and a new cylinder head with two spark plugs per each cylinder. This solution made room to increase the diameter of the intake valves, leading to a 5% increase in horsepower compared to the single plug head once the engine was prepared for racing. Alfa Romeo repeated the trick in the lower displacement category with the GTA 1300. Presented in 1968, it proved to be even more successful on track than its larger sister, doing wonders for Alfa Romeo image and mystique. Designed with the Italian market in mind, the Giulia was considered too small on many export markets. To address that, Alfa Romeo developed the 1750, equipped with a 1.8 liters engine derived from the existing 1.6 liters unit. With a longer stroke and a larger bore, the cylinder head was modified as well, with enlarged intake valves. For 1971, the Arese engineers managed to stretch the venerable twin cam one final time, adding more millimeters to the cylinder bores to create a 2 liters engine. These engines would be carried over onto the Alfetta and the new for 1977 Giulietta models. The sharp, wedge-shaped saloon would also be the last model to offer the base 1.3 engine, made available for the Italian market until 1983. The first turbocharged Alfa Romeos have been two homologation specials developed by the Racing Arm Auto Delta. The reason behind the GTV Turbo Delta's existence was the need to sell 400 turbocharged road cars for Auto Delta's rally program. The 1983 Giulietta Turbo Delta was developed to eventually replace the GTV6 on the European Touring Car Racing Championships, but the planned batch of 500 cars was never completed. The first series produced turbo Alfa Romeo is the 75 Turbo from 1986, equipped with electronic fuel injection and a Garrett turbocharger with intercooler. The performance was comparable, if not superior, to the naturally aspirated 2.5 V6 engine, which the new model was going to replace on the racetracks. Interestingly, on the homologation special 75 Evoluzione, the capacity of the 1.8 liters turbo engine was slightly reduced to stay within racing regulations. The Alfa Romeo engineers loved their dual side draft carburetors. The use of one throttle body per each cylinder permitted more overlap in the engine's timing, giving Alfa's engines their generous torque at low to medium RPMs. This was a problem though, as time was running out for those sexy sets of Weber 40mm carburetors. The Spica mechanical fuel injection system, which used a time injection pump derived from diesel engine applications, was a smart stopgap measure, but to retain the performance its customers expected in the era of electronic fuel injection, Alfa Romeo created the first VVT system ever fitted on production cars. First introduced on the American Spider in 1980, then in Europe on the 1984 Alfetta Quadrifoglio Oro, the variator allowed to adjust the timing of the intake valves on the Alfa 2 liters engine. By 1989, the variator was fitted to the 1.8 and 1.6 twin cams fitted to the 75. A 2 liters fuel injected engine would be the last classic B albero to leave the Arese production lines under the bonnet of a Spider in 1993. However, those last models were sold as 94 in the US. Production of the first generation of twin spark engines, which still used the classic Alfa engine block, continued until 1998, but that's a story for another time.